Two men who allegedly raped the son of Philippine actor Nino Mulak are charged by the Justice Department with sexual assault. State prosecutors on Wednesday filed the cases against Jojo Nones and Richard Cruz with a Pasay City court. Acting Prosecutor General Richard Fadulyon insists the case has all the elements to show that Sandro Mulak was sexually assaulted. Fadulyon rejects allegations that Mulak's delay in reporting his experience and his seemingly normal behavior after the incident indicates he was not sexually abused. Philippine police now have custody of three suspects in the kidnapping of American blogger Elliot Eastman. The 26-year-old Eastman was seized by armed men on October 17 near his home in Zamboanga del Norte province. The names of the three suspects have not been revealed, but National Police spokesperson Brigadier General Jean Fajardo says they are members of the Norjan Sandag criminal group. The three suspects have been charged by the provincial prosecutor with kidnapping and serious illegal detention. Investigators believe Eastman's abductors are holding him captive in Zamboanga del Norte. No ransom demand has been made.
So, lumalabas initially sa ating pong investigation, at least sa investigation po ng task group po ay kidnapping po talaga ang motibo po dito. But until now ay wala pa po tayong nakukuha na information na may demand po for ransoms.
69 foreigners and 47 Filipinos are arrested in a raid on an online scam hub in Manila. Most of the foreigners are Chinese. Police confiscated computers and other electronic gadgets from an office being used for online scamming operations. The Immigration Bureau has yet to verify whether the arrested foreigners are in the country illegally.
They are looking for a relationship, and at the end, they're asking yung tao, yung victim, na to invest into a cryptocurrency. We will be extracting other pieces of evidence na pwede natin makita sa computers or cell phones or any digital device. And then that will be the time na we will be checking kung sino ba ang pwedeng responsible dun sa commission ng krimen.
Complaints of serious illegal detention are filed with the Philippine Justice Department against 8 Chinese nationals linked to an illegal offshore gaming hub in Tarlac Province. The chief of the Philippine Police Criminal Investigation and Detection Group says the complainants themselves are two Chinese nationals. Police Brigadier General Nicolas Torres says the complainants and the respondents are in their custody. The accused Chinese were part of an offshore gaming hub in Bamban, the hometown of dismissed mayor and alleged Chinese spy Alice Goh. Over 800 Filipinos and foreign nationals were rescued when authorities raided the hub in March. The Danish firm Maersk opens its largest Philippine distribution center. Philippine President Marcos Jr. welcomes the new jobs it will create. Pia Gutierrez filed this report.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Wednesday led the launch of the Maersk Optimus Distribution Center, a massive 10-hectare, 76,000-pallet capacity facility in Calamba, Laguna, which is seen to boost the country's import and export activities, particularly in southern Luzon. According to Maersk, their largest facility in the Philippines will integrate major warehouse operational and co-packing activities to cater to key industry verticals such as consumer goods, food and beverage, leisure and lifestyle, healthcare, technology, automotive, and retail. It is also expected to create direct employment for 1,000 people in its surrounding communities, as well as indirect employment for another 1,000 individuals. Let's listen to President Marcos Jr. as well as Dominic Gates, the global head of the Maersk Contract Logistics.
With the grand opening of the Maersk Optimus Distribution Center, our logistics system will be a step closer to become a powerful force, bridging our islands, breathing life into our industries, our businesses, bringing together our people on a path towards sustained development.
The completion of this facility stands as a powerful symbol of Maersk's global commitment to a new and brighter future for the Philippines. I'm very excited about the Philippines generally. It's not just our largest market in ASEAN. It's going to be one of our top drivers going forward for many, many years.
The strategic location of the distribution center aligns with the administration's efforts to decongest Manila and unlock the economic potential of the countryside. Despite the challenges experienced during the pandemic, the Philippine logistics sector currently employs about 3.68 million Filipinos, ranking second only to the construction sector as the fastest growing industry in the Philippines. The president also noted that the Philippines logistics sector has shown marked improvement in competitiveness, climbing to the 43rd spot out of 139 economies in the World Bank's 2023 Logistics Performance Index from its previous place at 60th in 2018. He attributes this to the sector's gains in customs efficiency, infrastructure quality, and on-time deliveries.